You're watching News West 9 at 10. I'm Tatum Guinn. Hey, thanks for staying up late with us on News West 9 at 10. I'm Tatum Guinn. Thanks for joining us tonight at 10. I'm Tatum Guinn. For this a little later, News West 9 at 10. I'm Tatum Guinn. Did y'all just see Sean White? Y'all, he made me cry. Oh my goodness. Let's get into the news now. We have previewed the races, interviewed candidates, talked state propositions, and now we are finally here. It is election night 2021. We've got team coverage for all of the races that you care about here in West Texas. If you're just now joining us, we are working to gather more information about a small plane crash in North Midland County. We know it was a private plane went down in a field along North County Road 1150. That is where Jonathan Polosik, he's been out there for the past two-ish hours. Jonathan, do you have any new information at this time?
Now, that Arctic blast racing across Texas and bringing freezing conditions. Here's the good news. We have seen storms like this before. Last year's deep freeze, it was an anomaly. Keep that in mind, please. Now, the last big winter storm, it showed us how our electricity is heavily dependent on natural gas providers. Nearly 50% of our power plants run on natural gas.
Call it a nation in crisis, a different kind of pandemic, and no, I'm not talking about COVID-19. And tonight, we are all Andrews Mustangs. In the 3 days since the bus crash filled with members of the Andrews Marching Band, West Texans have banded together to show their community, you are not in this alone. You know the homeowner he's accused of shooting and killing, and Midland Police Officer Nathan Heidelberg. This afternoon, the trial went into recess before it even started. So why? People involved in the jury selection process, like jurors and lawyers, have tested positive for COVID-19 over the weekend. Now, while we are on the subject of Greenwood, yes, we have seen the messages and emails from viewers about a civil lawsuit filed against the school district. It's circulating around social media, too. We've chosen not to dive into the details of it. We are keeping a close eye on this case. You need to know that.
Meanwhile, Governor Abbott, he says the grid is holding strong in spite of the bone-chilling cold, and demand for electricity stayed below ERCOT's projections. Here's a look at real-time data from ERCOT at this hour. The thin purple line, a reminder, is the amount of power available right now. The turquoise line is the amount being used, and the space between the two represents how much power is in reserve. So, as you can see, we've got plenty. We're doing good. So what does all of this mean for you? Well, here's where we come in. The rising tensions are already impacting the price of gas. The national average is now $3.44 a gallon, a dollar more than Americans were paying this time a year ago, and it's the highest it's been in 8 years. One more travel trouble to throw at you. If you have a flight tomorrow, keep a close eye on your flight status. The airlines out of Dallas, Love, and DFW, which, by the way, is where a majority of our flights connect to, have canceled or delayed hundreds of flights so far. Midland has delayed or canceled a handful of flights today itself. West Texas making waves across the Lone Star State, seismic waves. We've been talking a lot about this. The earthquakes in our area have not just been picking up the pace, they're getting stronger. Tonight numbers are backing up that. The amount of earthquakes of magnitude 3.0 and higher in Texas doubled last year, up to 209 from the 98 recorded in 2020.
All right, let's talk a little weather. We hear stories of wild weather all the time. Most of the time it's happening out here. We're really in for another cold, foggy night in West Texas. So the question of the evening.
Right, what is it?
Yeah, what is it? How does it happen? I tried to explain it before the show and I was wrong. Mm-hmm. Anthony, how you hanging in there? Hope okay. We've got record heat.
Yep.
We had strong winds. Earthquakes, more than one. Tonight, thunderstorms. You've been a busy guy.
I have a feeling this year might be the most special yet. My friends, we've got a wonderful show for you. We've got great music. We've got our choirs. Hey, kids. I said this a minute ago to the crowd. They're looking great. We've got that. And Anthony, even.
Yep.
We have a very special guest who will join us on stage here in a little while, but closer to the tree lighting.
Okay, I've got to point out the most alarming thing Brendan said, and it's not anything about tomorrow's forecast.
Oh, there you go.
The guy's already listening to Christmas music.
You're one of them.
I'm one of them.
Anthony Franz and I are both in the right, saying that, no, it's not a toy. It's part of the ecosystem, people, and we don't play with the ecosystem. It's even a question that we pose to you at home. Is Santa a toy? And it looks like a bunch of you are on the right side of history. 53% of our respondents said that it is not a toy. Mason, do you have anything to say for yourself?
I mean, come on. We're talking about the national
Toy Hall of Fame. National. I mean, I would think that they know what they're talking about. You know, I mean, sure, you don't play with the environment, but I played with sand all the time as a kid. Come on.
Did you eat sand?
Probably. Maybe a little bit, but that's aside from the point.
No one is out on the roadway, so everyone is starting to heed those cautions. Another empty I-20 and West Loop 250. Thank goodness, everybody. Again, if you don't have to get out, don't. Make no plans tomorrow. And I said so you better not.
Thanks, man. I love this time of year. The cooler weather, that football weather, playoffs, nothing better than that. Hey, before we go to break, I wanted to share this photo with y'all. It might look just like an everyday regular picture of some teenagers, but if you look a little closer, there's a celebrity right there. Let's give you a closer look. Yes, sir. Midland was graced by the presence of Midland High graduate and former Olympian Bryce Hopple.
Sir, I'm hiding right now, right here. Look at this whole thing.
A first-hand account of one man's plea from Afghanistan. In hiding and fearing for his life.
The situation is getting worse.
It is dire. People rushing the Kabul airport, desperate to get out by any means necessary. Former Green Beret Joseph Torres has watched it all play out.
The hard part of seeing like something like that is that I know where that's at exactly.
It's a nightmare. Torres served 8 tours of duty as a Green Beret, 7 of them in Afghanistan.
Took a week to undo what we did in 20 years. My work negated. That's how I feel, and I'm angry at it.
That's because, for him, it's personal.
I know what's gonna happen.
You see, the man in this video is his friend. To protect his identity, he goes by Mikey.
Talk to him every day and hope that I hear from him the next day.
Mikey worked with U.S. troops as a translator.
The time I deployed to Afghanistan, he was my first call.
And now he is in danger because of his work with the U.S. military. Mikey and Torres have been in near constant contact.
He's in the hospital right now.
Mikey trying to flee with his family. Today, he was one of the many who rushed the airport. He sent a voice memo along with video.
I'm standing at the airport right now, right next to the army guys. Between me and the army guys is just only a barbed wire.
Hours later, another update.
I mean, he's desperate.
His wife and son both shot at the airport. Torres, a world away, also desperate to help his friend.
It hurts because any time that we were down there, he would help us, and now I can't go help him. I can't go get on a plane, and that bothers me. It hits me, you know, personally, on a very personal level. All I can hope is that my friend makes it out alive somehow, makes it to a border, or somebody comes through with help for him specifically, and we get him out of there.
The result of a decades-long war. And the question tonight, for what? There are no shortcuts out here. Life moves at a different pace.
We're all about the craft, you know, we don't take shortcuts.
And that's how it should be. You have the time and space to create something pretty special out here. That's exactly what pitmaster Philip Mullering and head brewer Amy Oxenham have done. Feast your eyes on this. Picture-worthy barbecue and craft beer that'll have you calling home.
I think that it's cool that you can find quality, unique, highly crafted beer way out in the middle of the Chihuahuan Desert.
You can find Brick Vault Brewery and Barbecue in Marathon. Population 427. Set up in an old converted gas station. It is the last stop before heading south to Big Bend National Park. And the most remote brewery in the entire country.
You know, our nearest brewery neighbors are more than 200 miles away in every direction.
Even so, people seek out the queue and the brew.
Those two things together is like unstoppable.
They like, we had no idea this was out here. You know, like how are y'all doing it way out here?
And perhaps that's the biggest draw. Way out here, there's great food, something cold to sip on, in a setting that makes you forget about your troubles, at least for a little while.
I mean, it's so slow-paced that people don't, there's not really a worry to be had out here, really.
Honoring the incredible natural beauty that we have and just adding to a list of a whole host of reasons of why people should come out here and enjoy this incredible natural beauty that we have.
A kind of beauty that can only be found in a place that is uniquely West Texas.